In this video, we'll explore how to fine-tune a language model using a completely code-free approach with Google Cloud technology. Let's discuss what we're trying to achieve and then dive into the process using Google AI technology, specifically Vertex AI. Language models, particularly open-source ones like Llama, are essential for building custom AI and machine learning workflows. Our goal is to use Google Cloud's Vertex AI to create a fine-tuned model from a base Llama 3 model. This process will result in your very own custom-tuned model for specific tasks. To fine-tune our model, we'll need training data. This data will come from Google Cloud Storage, an object store system that will feed into our language model fine-tuning workflow. This approach is no-code and very approachable even if you're not highly technical, making it an excellent alternative to more complex fine-tuning systems. We'll start by visiting the Model Garden, which is the central repository for both open source and proprietary models in Google Cloud. Here you'll find models like Palm 2 and Gemini, which are Google exclusive, as well as the Llama family of models. We'll be using Llama 3 for this demonstration. To begin, you'll need to accept the end user license agreement and ensure that your API is enabled for the project. Once that's done, you'll have access to the fine-tuning capability. For our fine-tuning job, we have two main options, an 8 billion parameter model for text completion and an 8 billion parameter model for chat. Next, we need to specify an output directory, which will be a cloud storage bucket. Since this is a new project, we'll create a new bucket. We'll select a single region instead of a multi-region bucket to keep costs lower. For the fine-tuning parameters, we'll adjust the number of epochs, which represents the number of complete passes through the training data. We'll also set a learning rate. These are the main configuration parameters for our fine-tuning job. If we look at the detailed tuning configuration, we can see additional options like layer-based fine-tuning, dataset specifications, and hardware choices. For this job, we'll be using 4 NVIDIA L4 GPUs. Google Cloud provides a sample tuning dataset, which we'll examine to understand its structure. We'll download this dataset and explore it in the Cloud Shell for easier analysis with bash commands. After downloading the sample dataset, let's explore its contents. A quick analysis shows us that we have about 500 lines in our dataset. Each line represents a separate training example for fine-tuning. Let's examine the first few lines of the file. We can see that the data follows a format similar to OpenAI's structure for prompts and responses. Each example consists of a messages array containing user questions and corresponding model responses. With 500 examples, our training time should be manageable. However, we'll still be using powerful L4 GPUs to ensure efficient processing. It's worth noting that while we have the option to automatically deploy the model after fine-tuning, we'll leave that unchecked for now to allow for more flexibility in our experimentation. Now, let's start our fine-tuning job. Oh, we've encountered an error. It seems we don't have access to the default Compute Engine service account. This is likely because our project is brand new and we haven't used Compute Engine yet. To resolve this, we need to enable the Compute Engine API. This step is crucial as the fine-tuning process requires some underlying infrastructure. With the Compute Engine API enabled, let's try launching our fine-tuning job again. Success! Our tuning job is now underway. We're using the Vertex AI Pipeline service for this process, which allows us to monitor the progress and observe the various steps of the pipeline. The main step in our pipeline is the tune model step, which utilizes our GPUs. All we need to do now is wait for the pipeline to complete its execution. Great news! Our pipeline has completed successfully. Although we skipped the optional deployment step, we can verify our training success by checking the model registry. Indeed, we can see our newly fine-tuned model listed there. Now that we have our fine-tuned model, the next step is deployment. Let's create an endpoint for our model. We'll need to choose the appropriate hardware for serving our model. The system recommends a single L4 GPU, so let's try to replicate that in our deployment configuration. As we scroll through the hardware options, we find the G2 standard machines, which include our L4 GPUs. We'll select an L4 machine and use the Compute Engine default service account. We'll also enable logging, but we won't need any additional features for now. With our configuration set, we can create the endpoint with our deployed model. This process might take a few minutes, similar to our fine-tuning step. Once our model is deployed and the endpoint is active, we have several options for testing and using it. For those comfortable with command line tools, you can use curl to send requests to the model. Alternatively, you can use the Vertex AI SDK, which provides simple Python code for interacting with the model. This SDK is particularly helpful for handling authentication and other common tasks. However, for a quick demonstration, we can use the Deploy and Test feature directly in the Google Cloud Console. This allows us to test our model right away without any additional setup. To test our model, we need to format our request correctly. The documentation provides guidance on how to structure these requests. Let's navigate back to the endpoint page and grab the sample request format. We can then use this as a template for our test. It's worth noting that the code samples provided might not always be as rich or detailed as we'd like. In such cases, we can often find more comprehensive examples on the Vertex AI page or the specific model page, in this case, the Llama 3 page. Now, let's go ahead and test our model using the Cloud Console interface for our endpoint. We'll use an instances-based approach, providing a prompt and any other necessary parameters for the model. After sending our request, we receive an output from the model. It's important to remember that we're using the non-chat version of the model, which is tuned for text completion rather than question answering or chat interactions. This means the output might not always be in a conversational format, but rather a continuation of the provided text. We'll provide the diagram from today's tutorial in the video description, and we'll keep an eye on the comment section for any questions. Thank you for watching, and please enjoy responsibly.